Howdy, folks. Welcome to round two here. This is not the best opener ever, but our mana looks good, and we have a mana dork. We got a scry on turn two. Can, like, potentially scry away a land, get a little bit more juice going on. Definitely not a hand that you mulligan. I like leading with the Arbor Elf, because it gives us more, as opposed to the Temple, this gives us more potential explosive rips off the top. Careful study, interesting. We might be facing Reanimator here. Maybe we can take a Grizzlebrand with the Zealous Conscripts, draw some cards. That could be fun. In Legacy Birthing Pod, I played Legacy like Bug Pod for a bit, and I definitely beat my fair share of Reanimator decks by getting down a turn two Birthing Pod, and then they reanimate a Grizzlebrand, and then I like pod a Mana Dork into a Phantasmal Image. And then, like, draw a bunch of garbage, and my bunch of garbage beats the deck that's just, like, a pile of dazes and stuff, you know? And, like, Deceiver Exarch, tap down your Grizzlebrand, attack you with my Grizzlebrand, that sort of thing. Anyway, it's a lot of fun. Pod just makes for fun moments like that. I think I actually want this, right? Because it can blow up some reanimation effects. I think I have to basically keep anything that's not a land at this point. Kind of glad we were on the play. Barrant Overlord doesn't seem like the most exciting. Because he gets two. Maybe it's fine. So they sacrifice a creature here, and then get to attack us for seven. And then sacrifice another creature. Attack for six. Just doesn't seem like quite enough damage, right? We could attack for 9 this turn. We could hit them down to 3 by going Zealous Conscripts, take your Overlord, attack you for 9. That's kind of exciting. Is that better than Slime? I don't think so. I'm going to Slime. Well, maybe. Kind of close. Holding onto the Slime is nice in case they are sitting on Animate Dead. Or drawn to one, you know? Zealous Conscripts is nice. If we rip Splinter Twin, then we can, like, immediately combo off. Yeah, let's go with this plan. Okay, cool. So it looked like it wouldn't have mattered what our line was. Gets me down to 7. So even if they have a creature to sacrifice. Oh, they're sacking the Overlord to mind bend me? Interesting. Interesting. What do you even take? Like, the Slime can threaten to trade with the Mindbender, but the Zealous Conscripts is just representing, like, a pile of damage. You know, like, 8 damage, get them down to 4. That's kind of tricky. I hope I stop drawing land soon. I hope I draw some juice, right? Okay, they take the Conscripts. Like, being able to just, like, duplicate the Mindbender would be hot. Or get a Wyrmcoil down or something. Ooh, the old Brainstorm into Serum Visions. So they get a little bit of value off the scry on the Serum Visions. I'm actually gonna check. They bottom bombed, okay. Can't really afford to let a Mindbender smack me around, so. Oh god. Alright. Alright, that's a pretty good victimize. Arc Trail, is that any good? It's kind of good. Yeah, it's okay. Be a lot better if we still have this Zealous Conscripts in our hand. So 2 damage, 1 damage. Clear those. Rawr. Lord Sacks a Harpy. Can attack me down to 1. That's why you don't fetch randomly when your life total matters. And now they need to play a creature to sack to the Overlord. Game's been interesting. Oh, we draw a Birthing Pod. Let's attack before we do anything else here. Although if they played like a soft counter on the Birthing Pod, it might be better to have the Arbor Elf up. 2, 3, 4. Wall of Blossoms, Fauna Shaman, Caryatid. Next turn we can go Pestermite into a 4-drop. I'm just going to get Wall of Blossoms, I think. In case the opponent has another removal spell. Oh, interesting, okay. So now we can go Pelucranos into... Oh, we don't have any 5-drops. We don't have any 5-drops. There's only 2 5-drops in here, and they are in our graveyard. That's highly unfortunate. So the duplicate, or the Birthing Pod chain, can't actually find me duplicant here. Oh, this is gnarly. How much mana do I have? Not enough. I was thinking get Spark Mage, have Spark Mage pop the Cura bubble. And then Pelucranos activate, but instead I think I'm going to go Pestermite, untap Birthing Pod. Find a Huntmaster, gain 2 life. I could also just get a Pestermite in play, right? I could just get a Pestermite in play, untap a land, and then just like play Pelucranos or something, or a Solemn. Like, I like the idea of getting the Pelucranos in play because it represents lethal in and of itself. Because if I get the Huntmaster and then something goes wrong, we'd gain 2, we'd go up to 3. We would not be representing lethal. Yeah. I think the opponent's got 3 cards in hand. I think this is slightly better. If we had one more land, if this Misty Rainforest was not a pain land, we could do everything, right? We could untap the Birthing Pod, pod the Pestermite into Huntmaster, play a Pelucranos, be in solid shape, but it's not the case. I'm just thinking, make sure there's not another 4-drop. Oh, that's just Huntmaster. Okay. Well, hope my opponent doesn't kill me here. Because they just need to clear the Pestermite to get in. The nice thing about getting the Huntmaster is we'd be like, we wouldn't die to any old removal spell, any old goal for the throw, right? The downside to the Huntmaster is the opponent could just attack us with the Kira down to one again. And then what, right? Then what are we doing? We're potting away our wolf token to like find a Birds of Paradise to chump with. Like, is that the line? Also not very exciting, right? Okay, Thassa doesn't do it. Not this turn. And they actually can't Thassa on the Kira without popping the shield, so if they have to do it twice, then we can like kill it with the Pleukranos. That's actually kind of exciting. And meanwhile, we're representing lethal. Yeah, that's both players, buddy. I'm sorry. Opponent's deck's kind of interesting. I've never seen Reanimator hybridized with the Mono Blue Devotion deck. Usually it's, I mean, I've seen Mono Blue Devotion hybridized with a couple of things, but not actual factual Reanimator. That's real interesting. I guess it works pretty well with Luteril Core. Like, Luteril Core works with both. Merfolk Looter works with both. Jace Vryn's Prodigy. Anyway, you get the idea. So the Pleukranos by itself is lethal, so there's no reason not to attack with both here. And the Kira has to chump. And then they take two down to six. We can pot away Pestermite while we're thinking about it. And we have no five drops, no four drops left in our deck. This is kind of the problem with Birthing Pod in Limited, right? You just have a smaller deck to work with. I actually think it might be interesting to build a larger Birthing Pod deck in Limited. Like, intentionally go above 40 cards. The problem is that you only have one Birthing Pod, right? So you're actually decreasing the consistency. Once you have a Birthing Pod in play, it gets much better if you go above 40 cards, but you're decreasing the consistency of your deck by skewing the pod itself. Which you can maybe make it work if you're playing in a cube that has enough like tutors, if you can tutor for the pod. Or if, practical tutors like Zealous Conscripting for your opponent's Nahiri to ultimate and tutor for the pod. Things that where you can consistently get a Birthing Pod in play. No, but seriously, Eldritch Evolution is another one that could potentially serve a kind of pod role, you know? Anyway, Kega seems a little bit better than usual against what my opponent is doing. I'm so happy that we won that game. I'm just not really sure what I would want to cut for it, right? Arc Trail actually seems good in this matchup. I'm going to cut the Spark Mage, actually. Not that the Spark Mage is dead, but I think Kega is just a little bit more powerful. Yeah, and that almost wants me to, like, it makes me want to play another 5-drop just so that I don't run out. Like, maybe cut Pleukranos for Deranged Hermit. I kind of like that idea. But then we're down to 2 4-drops. Then we have that problem. We can't cut a 3-drop. There's only 3 3-drops. Can't cut a 2-drop. Could cut Arc Trail, maybe. I don't think so, though. I think Arc Trail is pretty strong. Kind of won us that game, right? Yeah, it's usually better to have more 5-drops than 6-drops, for sure. But I think this might be the exception that proves the rule. And Catacomb Sifter is actually a really good value dude with Birthing Pod and Recurring Nightmare. It's okay with Recurring Nightmare. Get some nice scry action in. We're just not getting black mana consistently early enough to play the Sifter, I don't think. Way easier for us to get blue. Yeah, let's try this. Yeah, not a as good as Dismember is. This is not a keeper. What about this hand with a scry, right? We've got, like, what, 10 green sources in here? Something like that. 8 comes into play on tap green sources, I think. 8 or 9. I can't really remember. I think this hand's actually fine with a scry. Let's run it. Yeah, never didn't have it. I almost wish my opponent would, like, probe me or something on turn one. Be like, oh, okay. Yeah, he kept on top. Okay. Yeah. You know. I think we're going to jam Sylvan Library on turn two. As opposed to Wall of Blossoms. I don't think Wall of Blossoms does a ton here. The old sorcery speed brainstorm. Sometimes you just need to chew through your deck, though, right? Especially in limited, like, brainstorm is not... You generally don't have, like, a critical mass of shuffle effects for brainstorm. I mean, a really good limited deck can. But sometimes it's just... You just want, like, a single blue draw card, right? Like, my opponent has Talrand in their deck. And so brainstorm is probably not in here as a filter effect so much as a one mana draw a single card. Put a 2/2 flyer into play, right? Like, that's all they're about there. Deathrite Shaman, interesting. Alright, Sylvan Library. Awesome. How much do I want to pay? I think just 4. And then I have to consider if I want to dismember the Death Rite or not. I think I don't necessarily. Not quite yet. I'll feel silly if they pass with mana, obviously, to activate Brainstorm, and it seems correct to dismember the Death Rite, but I don't see that happening. Interesting. You exile it at the beginning of the end step. Oh, one cool thing about the end of turn dismember on Deathrite Shaman is if the opponent had remand in hand, then they would remand that, and then the slime wouldn't get remanded. Here, I'm pretty sure I go cultivate. Let's put Yavimai Elder on top. If I go cultivate, then I can't go slime. Yeah, this line's way, way worse if the opponent has a remand, but the cultivate plus wall of blossoms line didn't really appeal to me. Looks like they're doing something. Fencer? That's fine. Is that worth dismembering? I think so. I think it just is. It's a lot of pain, especially when the opponent has a death rite in play, but I think we'll get over it. We'll see. The one bummer is that it puts a awesome value creature in their graveyard for victimize. Okay, well now we have to cultivate into Wall of Blossoms. Opponent has a fairly reasonable victimized deck here. I'm kind of glad they didn't get the recurring nightmare. That would have been a real nightmare. Oh, this is just game two, right? We have 11 minutes on the clock. It's not quite enough for a game two. I'll try and play a little bit faster. It's awkward when we've got all these triggers and whatnot, and Splinter Twin combo, and so on and so forth. But I think the opponent's either going to like kill me fairly quickly here, or we'll end up winning the game. So not super worried. Okay, it's a good reanimate. Bounce or bounce Arbor Elf, I imagine. I think bouncing Arbor Elf makes more sense than bouncing a land here. Oh, just wants to get in the extra 2 points of damage. I'm just trying to close the game. Okay. And back to you. Okay, that drains us down to 6. Opponent's got 1 card left in hand. They're at 15. I would love to twin up this Huntmaster, but we'll see. We'll see how this turn goes. Do I survive? Technically. Oh no, technically not. All right. Guess I have to block with the Huntmaster. Yeah, because the reanimate's in the graveyard, so it's a strong attack for sure, for sure. Well, that's almost good. A little short on mana, though. I guess I should have dismembered the Deathrite Shaman, right? I thought about it. It's definitely a consideration. Yeah, so any spell kills me. Deathrite Shaman attacking would just get me down to 1. Which wouldn't be the best, because then they lose the Drake. Zealous Conscripts taking Deathrite Shaman so that I can gain 2 life would be interesting. Toxic Deluge. Is that even good? Oh, it puts a spell in the graveyard for the Deathrite Shaman. Okay, he's playing for 0. That's fun. That's funny. Okay, now we have 9 minutes and 50 seconds for a game 3, which is plenty of time. I think I like Electrolyze in this matchup. Now that I've seen more of the opponent's deck, I think Electrolyze is really good. Electrolyze or Chain Lightning, or both. Like, more so than Dismember. Do I like Electrolyze over, though? The Kaiga, maybe? Yeah, definitely. Just be a little bit more efficient, you know, efficient with my mana. Spark Mage, we've seen 2 uses for Spark Mage now. There's the Necrotal as well. Can't think of anything else, though. That's not quite enough. It's close. It's borderline. P&K would be kind of good. If I can get it into play, it might be better than Pelucranos in this matchup. Yeah, let's rock this. Sure. Misty gonna get Volcanic Island, so I'm probably gonna get a swamp, and our mana should be solved from day one. I'm just gonna fetch now. There's a chance we actually go for the twin combo this game. We can't do it on turn four unless we naturally draw the Pestermite. Blood Artist? Sure. Interesting. I do like the idea of discarding Wurmcoil Engine. So I don't just want to get Pestermite in this situation. Because then the opponent like thinks like, oh man, something's up. We could use the Pestermite as a little bit of disruption, but I don't really like that either. I think, let's see here. I want to get something where it's like not suspicious that I just pass with four mana up. So like Acidic Slime could fit that bill. Or maybe Duplicate. Discard Wurmcoil Engine, go get another uncastable creature. I could just slam a PNK. That's like not bad, right? The problem with getting the slime is if the opponent's sitting on remand and they like need their mana, then they hold up remand and then the twin combo doesn't work. So it's kind of a tricky business, isn't it? If I do get Pestermite, then I get to just attack, which is kind of cool. Get in that damages. Opponent's on four cards. I think if they had a Go for the Throat, then they would have just killed the Fauna Shaman instead of playing Blood Artist. I don't think playing the Blood Artist does much for them. Okay, I'm just going to get the Pestermite then. Yeah, I want to discard this Shaman, so I guess I just pass. Yeah, this is all highly suspicious. Oh, wow. What could go wrong? Oh, no. They had a thing. Okay. Not my finest hour. Ooh la la. I hope I don't lose this game just because I'm, like, constrained on mana. Yeah, that's fine. So reanimate here is actually kind of gnarly, because you can reanimate the Wormcoil engine that I discarded earlier. Yeah, that's what just happened. Let's see. I guess I just get some bodies in play, huh? Probably should have chain lightning this thing a long time ago. And maybe I should have solemned on this turn and gotten a swamp and then chain lightning to the Blood Artist. This way I get to clear the Liliana, though, which is kind of nice. I don't want to just, like, sit here and die to a Liliana. If I can avoid it, if that's a thing that I can avoid. Sure. Yeah, maybe I should have just gone for the slime game plan. And then once we reached this stage, like, gone for the twin combo. Or, like, once they passed with all that mana up, like, we knew they had at least Fencer in their deck. Each player discards a card. Okay. I think I can eat six here. I need to pod the P and K into an acidic slime to kill the animate dead. And then chain lightning the Blood Artist. So I'm going to lose, what, 4? 5? Yeah. Land? Land would be good. Okay. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of how I sequenced this game, obviously. I mean, just because a game isn't working out correctly doesn't mean that I missequenced it, but I kind of just wanted to, like, pull the trigger and get the easy victory. I was lured into the realm of, well, maybe I just win. And that's not how you win matches, that mentality. Still, Conscripts could kill a Wormcoil engine. I think I need to get the Kara off the board, maybe. And then we chain lightning the Blood Artist. They don't have two red up. Get down to two. One Thopter can attack Liliana of the Veil. And then I think I need to, like, naturally draw a black source or something wonky like that to get back my Wormcoil engine. I think that's, like, my way back into this game. Because duplicate's not very good here. Like, duplicate makes them sacrifice, which is not ideal. So my worm is back in my graveyard, where it belongs. Yeah, it seems impossible to both draw an awesome creature to pot away and a black source for recurring nightmare on this turn. I think we needed to stick Solemn earlier. Like, the turn that I went for Splinter Twin, I should have just played Solemn. And then I think we do actually win this game. Because then recurring nightmare would be an option here. Optione. Let's see, the Wall of Blossoms is in the graveyard. So there's no draw or anything. Yep. Not that we could get a 2-drop anyway, can only get a 1-drop. Alright, GG, well-played opponent. Oh well, deck was sweet. For sure. Deck was sweet. And definitely had some sweet games in there along the way, right? Even if I don't think we played the last match optimally, it's also a very tricky deck to play optimally when you've got Fauna Shaman and Birthing Pod and, like, your whole deck at your disposal. That's kind of what makes the deck rewarding to win with. And also, rewarding to win with in general. Because of all the complications. Because you're actually, like, playing with your entire deck and whatnot. And that's the excitement. Well, thanks everybody for watching. I'm pretty pumped that Legacy Cube is back on Magic Online. And I'm also pretty pumped for this Kaladesh set. I just played my first pre-release of Kaladesh, and I enjoyed myself greatly, so I look forward to producing a little bit of content for that format as well. Yeah, see you all next week.